What I'd like to tell you about in this video before moving on with our discussion of the celestial sphere is this thing here that, of course, is titled the horizon. Okay, so what the horizon is, I'll start with a little bit of drawing, and I'll have much, much more to show you about this. This is as follows here. If you're on the Earth like this, and you see the North and South poles, and suppose you're standing here on the Earth, and there's a bunch of stars around all over the place, and the stars, of course, can be they can also be the sun or the moon, but we'll just focus on stars for a minute. It turns out that if you look very carefully at this, you sort of think with the horizon, what stars can I see and what stars can't I see? So it seems like to me then that you'll definitely be able to see this star and all these stars over here. But as soon as you get a little too low behind the Earth, like say maybe down here, you're not going to be able to see this star. And it's not because it's not there, it's because the Earth is in the way. So if I draw some lines here, maybe some orange lines here to say, well, I can sort of see these stars and those stars and all these stars. I can see a bunch of these stars here. So I'm sort of drawing this fan out picture to indicate what stars I can see, because the pattern will emerge in a second. But it seems like as soon as I get sort of to around here, then I don't think I can see any of the stars below this last line right here. I can't see any stars below this line here. So these stars here, they're there, but I'm not going to be able to see them. Likewise, on the other side, probably this line is similar here, that sort of all of these stars down here, I just can't see them. And the reason why I can't see them isn't because it's cloudy or something magical is going on, or I'm just not looking right or something like that. What the horizon is very much is about here is the Earth is in the way. Very simple. The literal, the rocks, the land, the Earth gets in the way. I can't see through the Earth, so I can't see the stars, and that's what the horizon is. So, onwards. This is probably what you associate with a horizon, a beautiful beach view like this. And of course, this line here all the way in the distance, that is the horizon. And it's just what we said here. The water here, well, that's on the Earth. And of course, this is the sky right here. And it seems like there's more sky to see here. There's more sky to see down here. But as I sort of get down to that level, I can't see down past the horizon because that's where the Earth is getting in the way. That's where the Earth is in the way right here. Because literally, right here below this water point, there's probably some more clouds I'd like to see, but I can't see it because the Earth's in the way. And this is sort of most relevant for us, is it definitely happens at night, doesn't it? Because here's the sky, and here's the Earth, and maybe there's a city or trees or something on it, and there's plenty of stars I could see that are getting lower and lower. In fact, sort of right in here, there's probably a bunch of stars right down here I would like to see, but once again, I can't because the Earth got in the way. And that's what the horizon is. The horizon sort of, it's a limit to our view. Limit to our view of the sky. So let me just show you a few more things here about the horizon, sort of the nature of it here. As I said, the horizon limits to what we can see, and it definitely sets boundaries for the celestial sphere because we just can't see everything. So if I go back just for a moment to this model of the celestial sphere, and if I have you look over towards the right image here, and if you look at the right image there, you see sort of this stick figure person standing on this green grass, I guess it is, and that green grass is meant to represent the horizon. And so if I turn on a bunch of stars here like this, let me just get a bunch of stars here on the map, on the celestial sphere here, as I showed you, you can see here what the horizon does for the person. So they can see all these stars up above the horizon. So if you're sort of looking at the stars that are above the green bar, the person can see those, but they can't see the stars that are below the horizon. So underneath that green plate they're standing on, because they're below the horizon, the person can't see those. The stars are there, they're burning their gas, they're nice and bright, but you just can't see them because the Earth is in the way. Too bad. And so this is sort of the nature of the horizon. I made some graphics here to illustrate this effect. So what it is here is, of course, as you might guess here, this big blue thing here is the Earth. And I'm going to say that that little red thing right there, that's maybe you. Now, it isn't a nice person, but you can think of it as the opening to your eye or a camera, or just imagine that you're just a cylinder like that. So watch what happens when I sort of zoom in on you. So as you zoom and zoom and zoom and zoom and zoom and zoom, and there I am right on top of you, you can see this effect, the horizon all around you. So first of all, it looks very flat, because that's what spheres look like when you get very close to them. It look very flat. And as I sort of look over that way or down that way or over that way or up this way, I just can't see anything there because the view is cut off by the horizon. This yellow plane sort of also sets what the horizon might look like. You can sort of see it a little bit buried in there as it mixes with the blue and the yellow right there. But that's sort of this plane here. So in other words, this yellow plane, that would be my horizon. And so it's very much that yellow plane that you see here is very much like the green plane that you see over on the right half of this screen right here. It just limits my view. I can't see past that. And so that's sort of the horizon there. So this, of course, is the nice round Earth. But what happens then is if all these stars are up here, they're all over the place. Remember, stars are just sort of exist all over the place like this. These are the ones down here that I can't see, but these are the ones up here that I can see. So that if this is me right here sort of standing on the horizon here, as I look up, I can see all those stars. Okay, that's perfectly fine. But because I can't go down and see below the Earth, these are all the stars and things that I can't see. And so here's some images I just pulled off the internet about what this looks like here. If you know anything about calculus here, it turns out that the horizon is always a tangent plane to the Earth. And what the word tangent means, it just sort of touches the sphere in one spot, maybe where you're standing. And of course, these lines here definitely form the edges of my horizon. So if I was, once again, one little person standing right here, then these edges here would be the limits of my view. I can't see below the horizon there. And you can see some other shots of it. I mean, here's some shots here of the horizon this way, over here as well. And there's sort of a plane again. If I'm standing right at P, I could certainly see all the stars up here, but I wouldn't be able to see the stars down there because the Earth is in the way. So this is about the best we can draw. Little goofy figure like that here. And, you know, sort of for the last time, these stars up here are the ones I can see. These are the ones down here I can't see. And the reason that sets the visibility is just because the Earth here gets in the way. Now, I acknowledge that in the regions like this here, the Earth isn't necessarily on that red line anymore. But when you zoom in on the Earth, it's just this flat region right here, which sort of sets the horizon for the parts that I can't see. Okay, so the horizon is always very flat to us, although we know the Earth is very round. But if you zoom in a lot, you sort of get this flat horizon. That's why everything looks flat around us here. And as I'll show you in the next video then, this horizon part right here is going to have a lot to do with many, many aspects of the sky that we see, including what stars we can and can't see, and when stars rise and set. And so I'll show you that in the next video.